old timer.
Let's see what happened after that. Oh yeah.
Another day in paradise.
So what we're doing right now is just getting my girl saddled up. This is Tess. And one of the things I like to do with my horses, out of respect for them, is prepare them for each thing that I'm about to do. So it's a whole process. And these straps and buckles, and this is called a rear cinch, which is basically designed, I think ropers came up with it, the idea, because when they dally, the back of the saddle would pop up, launch them forward. So they came up with this idea, helps hold the back of the saddle down in place. Less stress on the front of the horse and less stress on the cowboy or cowgirl. Now, what I was saying earlier about repairing the horse, I've seen people take and cinch their horses up real tight right away. I don't do it. I do it as a gradual process, because the horse will hold its breath when you're cinching it. It takes a big breath and it expands itself. And then when you go out on trail or go out for your ride, the tendency is the saddle to slip, because the cinch opens up as the horse exhales and it's looser. The horse is pretty smart. So what I do is to keep the saddle from rolling and slipping is I do a gradual cinch. Like, I'll set that up like that and I'll leave it. I'll continue to do the rest of the work around the horse, putting on the different cinches and breast collars, which is what I'm putting on now, the breast collar, which helps hold the saddle in place so it doesn't slip forward when going up or down a hill. Helps keep the relationship of the saddle on the horse in its most optimum and comfortable place. So what I'll do is I'll continue to do that kind of work. Well, she can't hold her breath for so long, so she'll exhale in a little while, and then I can cinch her up a little bit more without putting any stress on her at all. What I'm doing right now is I'm putting on my splint boots. The reason I always recommend that people use splint boots on their horses, because this area here, there's a lot of tendons. And if you look at the horse, the way it's put together, it's very interesting. This is a very big and heavy animal, and it supports itself on these little tiny bits of legs. So like you would with a wristband or anything that you would use to protect the tendons, we put splint boots on our horses. That way it gives them a lot of support and helps from bowing those tendons, which is then a real problem for that horse.